Marcel Beugelsdijk from the Netherlands, owner of Bemint and specialized in Power Query. This is one of the videos in the series about global dates and times in Power Query. Power Query has no standard functionality to convert daytimes between time zones with clock switches because of daylight saving time or because of government decisions. In this video, I will demonstrate how you can convert UTC daytimes to daytimes in a time zone with clock switches, something that is regularly asked on forums. In order to do so, I will be using objects from workbook Bemint Daytime Between Fixed and DST Time Zone. You can find the link below the video and download the workbook for use at your own risk. This is actually the light version that can be used to convert daytimes between a time zone with a fixed UTC offset and a time zone with clock switches. There will be another workbook with full functionality to convert daytimes between multiple time zones with clock switches. More on those workbooks in other videos. Let's start with the demo by creating a new workbook. In the first place, you need a table for the time zone with clock switches. You can either create such a table yourself, as illustrated in another video in this series, or copy data from the table in the workbook Bemint Global Daytime Table 2015-2024. A link to this workbook is provided below this video. Another video is available with backgrounds about the corrections that are applied to the table. Next, you need to determine where you want to store that table with clock switches. Options are in an external workbook or in the current workbook. If you opt for the current workbook, you can find two options in workbook Bemint Daytime Between Fixed and DST Time Zone. Option 1 is to put your table in Excel table Global Clock Switches with queries Global Windows Daytimes to import the table in Power Query and query clock switches to select columns UTC and local after and to add column offset. Option 2 is to copy the values and paste them in the source tab of query clock switches pasted values. This is actually an interesting option as this comes from option enter data in Power BI Desktop, which is not available in Power Query in Excel, which is quite logical because you can maintain your own tables in Excel worksheets. Power BI Desktop doesn't have that option and enter data is an alternative. It can only be used for relative small tables. For instance, the entire table with 10-year clock switches for all Windows time zones doesn't fit. But one time zone is no problem. If you use this option, a query is created with some complex code that is only understood by computers. But you can copy the query to Power Query in Excel. And now you have the same functionality in Excel. This is what I did in query clock switches pasted values. By using the gear button next to the source tab, you get a pop-up with the same functionality as in Power BI Desktop. So you can either enter data or paste copied data. This is the option we will use in this example. So let's copy this query and paste in our new workbook. Let's rename this to just clock switches and go to the workbook Bemint Global Daytime Table and copy the data for one time zone. I choose Casablanca because it is an interesting time zone as it has 4 clock switches in some calendar years and it is either on UTC or on UTC plus 1 hour. So you can easily see in the examples if daylight saving time is applicable or not. Now I can paste the data in this table. A message appears stating that the first row has been promoted to column headers, which is just fine, so I choose OK. Documentation is included in the query summary step, which tells us that step result is no longer required when data is available in the source step. So let's remove it. Close and load. So now we have the table with clock switches. Let's create some example data. For now, I just copy worksheet example input from workbook bemint daytime between fixed and DST time zone. We don't need sheet 1 anymore. And the random values can be replaced by fixed values. Based values only. We don't need these lines. Delete. We can adjust the column header to UTC daytime and sort oldest to newest. So now we have our example input. We can create a query to have it imported in Power Query. Close and load to only create connection. So now we have our input. Before start building the output query, we need a conversion function. Copy, paste. Reference the input and rename to output. Before we proceed, let's take a look at the function. It is fully documented, as I will explain in another video. In the description and examples, it is clarified that you first need to convert table clock switches into a buffered list. This is done for performance reasons. The function performs two approximate lookups, and these are much faster if the lookup table is converted to a buffered list. Luckily, the code from the example can be copied. Going to the advanced editor of the output query, it is most convenient to paste this line of code before the source step in the output query. So you can proceed from the source step. Next, add column, invoke custom function, new column name, Morocco, daytime, because Casablanca is in Morocco, function query daytime between fixed and DST zone, daytime in originating time zone is column UTC daytime, to from the time zone with clock switches is to, because we convert UTC daytimes, the time zone with fixed UTC offset, to Morocco daytime with clock switches. If we would want to convert Morocco daytimes to UTC, we would choose from. The offset hours in the fixed time zone is 0 for UTC, and the same applies for the offset minutes. For the buffered clock switches list, we need to choose a column. Unfortunately, this is standard behavior of the user interface whenever a function has a parameter of type list. It expects that this would be a table column. A table column is actually a list. That is not true in our case, but the only thing we can do is just choose some table column and adjust the code that will be generated. By choosing query clock switches and column UTC, the generated code will be closer to what is actually required. Okay. Now we get all errors, but we can easily adjust the code by adding buffered and remove UTC. Let's also add type daytime just before the last parenthesis close. Now the query is ready and we can close and load. Let's verify the result. The standard time of Morocco is equal to UTC. And if Morocco is 1 hour ahead, then daylight saving time is active. So in January 2015, times are equal. And the first difference is on April 17, 2015, when there is 1 hour difference. In June, the clocks are equal, so daylight saving time is suspended. which can be seen in this table. 2015, daylight saving time is suspended between June 14 and July 19, 2015. So in January 2016, time is equal to UTC again. And July 14, 2016, we have an example with daylight saving time, and so on. So in this video, we saw how we can easily convert UTC daytimes to Morocco daytimes. Once we have a table with clock switches, our input, the function, daytime between fixed and DST zone, and the query output in which the function daytime between fixed and DST zone is actually used. So for this video, thanks for watching and see you again in another video about global daytimes in Power Query.